Hello everyone, I welcome you to my channel. Today I'm going to show you how to install the latest version of PyCharm on your Windows 11 operating system. So, let's begin. Now to install PyCharm, you need to first simply go to your favorite browser, and in the address bar, you need to just simply type PyCharm download, then enter. And then you'll be seeing this www.jetbrains.com is basically our first search result. So just simply click on download PyCharm, and this will going to redirect you to this official site of PyCharm, and you can clearly see that we are in download PyCharm. So in here under Windows we have professional one and community one. If you are using some other operating system like macOS or Linux, then you'll be getting the similar professional and community one. You need to just simply navigate to those tabs. But I am going to use it for Windows, so I'm going to simply click on this Windows tab, and from here I'm going to download the community one. So just simply click on this download button, and what it will do is it will going to start downloading our PyCharm, right? So since I have already downloaded it, I just simply cancel it, and if I just simply minimize my browser, and if I just simply go to my download directory, you can clearly see that I have PyCharm Community 2021.3 has been directly downloaded over here. Now to install, you need to just simply double click on it. And you can see that our PyCharm installation wizard has been directly opened. So for that, you need to first simply click on yes to provide administrative privileges. And our welcome to PyCharm Community Edition setup has been directly opened. So let us first minimize our download directory, and here you need to just simply click on next, and you can see this is going to be our destination folder. So if you want to change your installation destination folder, then you need to just simply click on browse, and you can do that, but I'm going to keep this as a default and then just simply click on next. And now under installation options, it is given some text boxes. So from here, the first one is whether you'd like to create desktop shortcut. So just I'd like to create a desktop shortcut like these other apps that you can see. I'd like to create a PyCharm community desktop shortcut. I'd also like to check add folder as project, so that any Python related project that I am created, I can rightly open in our PyCharm only. I'd also like to associate my PY file on using PyCharm. If you are doing any Python related project, then it is always recommended to check this. But if you are doing some machine learning related project, then you can uncheck this, because there are other softwares like Anaconda, Spider. So all those software are extensively used for machine learning. So if you are doing machine learning, then I recommend you do not check this, right? So that you can open those files in Spider itself. So that's the thing. And this is very important, guys. You need to check this add bin folder to path. This is very important, because what it will do is it will going to set our environment path in our variables, in our environment variables. So it is very important to set this path. Otherwise, you need to set this path manually, which is not at all recommended, I would say. So do check this and then just simply click on next. And you can see that our JetBrains folder, they're going to be created. So just simply keep this as a default, then just simply click on install, and it will going to start installing our PyCharm community edition. So you can see that it has rightly started. So this entire process will take a couple of minutes. So what I'll be doing is I'll be coming back right after installing our PyCharm. Yeah, so welcome back. And now as you can clearly see that our PyCharm Community Edition setup has been rightly installed, and it is asking whether you'd like to reboot now or you want to reboot manually later. So I recommend you to reboot now. So what it will do is it will going to set our environment path. So it is very important to set your reboot now. Right. So you after rebooting your system, I'll be again coming back. Yeah. So we'll come back. And now after successfully rebooting your system, you'll be seeing that our PyCharm Community Edition 2021.3 has been directly installed, and our desktop shortcut is also created. So just simply double click on it to launch our PyCharm Community Edition, and it will going to ask you whether you'd like to import PyCharm settings. So since I have not installed PyCharm earlier on this computer, I'll just simply click on Do Not Import Settings and then just simply click on OK. And our PyCharm Community 2021.3 will start launching. And it has rightly launched. So welcome to PyCharm. So let us first maximize it. And here I'm going to show you how to create a simple Hello World Python program and how to run them in our PyCharm IDE. So for that, first you need to simply click on this new project, and this will going to open this new project window. Here you need to give your project name. I'm going to give project name as a Hello World. You can give any project name as per your wish, and our location C, it is going to be Hello World, right? So they're going to create this PyCharm project directory, then Hello World project, they're going to be created. And base interpreter is Python 3.9. So if you have installed Python earlier, then it will going to be just simply find that path. But if you have not installed Python earlier, then it will going to start downloading Python before creating our project. So I'm going to keep this as a default and then just simply going to create. And you can see it is currently preparing to create our project. But as I have said earlier, before that it will going to install Python. So you can see that our Python 3.9.7 is currently downloading. So you need to have an active internet connection right throughout this installation. And by the time it will also going to ask you for administrative privileges. So again, you need to just simply click on yes so that our Python get installed in our system. So this entire process will take a couple of minutes. So what I'll be doing is I'll be coming back again after completion of this process. Yeah. So welcome back. And now as you can see that our project, Hello World project, has been rightly created. So just simply maximize it. And see, they have created our main method. So from our main method, they have created this print high. So this print high is getting called by passing this PyCharm as a parameter, and this is our print high method. So our PyCharm parameter is getting over here, and then it is printing high PyCharm. So if you just simply click on this run button, what it will do is it will going to print high PyCharm. See, high PyCharm rightly printed. But now let's say you change this PyCharm to any name. I'm going to just change it to high Geeky Script, and then just simply click on this run button. What it will do is it will going to print high Geeky Script over here, right? So in this way you can easily install the latest version of PyCharm on your Windows operating system. So that's basically all about this video, friends. Thank you very much for watching this video. If you like this video, then please give it a like, and so please do share it with your friends. Thank you very much for watching this video, and God bless you all.